So for a few thousand of years, humankind's enemies, there are three of them. The first one is the famine, and then the plague, we're experiencing one now, and then the war, right? It's unfortunately, these are unavoidable tragedies, but I'm cautiously optimistic that humankind can also take care of this COVID-19 because now we have more resources, more tools, more technology that we're going to deal with this. And for the past few months, we are actually relying on technology while working from home. This is just a sample survey where people using email, including that we're using now Zoom. So good morning. Thank you for having me, distinguished speakers and also the guests. So I put the title as digital retransformation because I witnessed this for the past 10 years. Indonesia has been experiencing digital transformation, but I think it's appropriate now if today we call it retransformation due to the AI as well as COVID, right? So my name is On Lee. I'm part of the GDP venture. So I'm going to make a quick introduction about GDP and then the background of this talk. And then discuss about the challenges and then how we deal with it. Okay, so I'm going to play a 1 minute video real quick.
We love to connect the science and the arts, the experience and the possibilities, the culture and partnership. The message and the innovation. We are here to connect the consumer and where they belong. To connect Indonesians with their unique needs. We are GDP Venture, empowering consumer culture.
So these are some of our companies. We mainly focus in investing in Indonesian startups. So here's some background. If we look back, this is the snapshot that I got from John Hopkins as of yesterday, right? We are about 4.7. If you notice on the right corner here, unfortunately, the chart show keep climbing up. There's no sign of flattening or even going down. So we are not out of the wood yet. Now, if we look for the past 700 years or so, we experienced many of these things, right? From Black Death, smallpox, Spanish flu, and the recent one in modern time, like SARS, that we all knew about it, right? Seems like yesterday, now we're experiencing it, COVID-19. So if this kind of thing, if we look independently, 60 years, we get through this many computer industry and today AI. Okay? And then while we are busy with all these things, and there's a quantum computing waiting in the wing as well. So every 8-10 years, we always have something new, a new breakthrough in technology, specifically in the computer industry. Now, if you look, as shown by Indonesia, if you look, we have this recent PSB, right? 25 company has been closed and some of them got warning because this new regulation, people are not used to with it, they're still learning about it. And then the other thing is working from home, you know, many companies working from home are kind of foreign concept, right? Unless you're 100% you're not used to this, right? Some company even today, like banking and hospital, for example, you cannot work from home, you just have to go to the office. So as a result, a mix of working from as well as working from off. And then the other challenge to work remotely. You manage remotely, all of many also become new, meaning by walking no longer apply here because everybody work virtually. And then the other thing is, number one is employees' health and safety, right? Because we need to protect our employees so they can continue running our business. And then because we work from home using a lot of technology, the side effect also, the criminals also taking advantages of it, right? And then not to mention the new social distancing or physical distancing. We have to follow the government new law in running our business. So all of this kind of becoming extremely challenging for a lot of companies and even in the EU. Now, if you look for these conveniences that working using digital, it's also cyber. This is just one example where Google claim it blocks 18 million email. That's COVID-related email, not to mention about other thing. And then FBI confirmed the same thing, and also the FTC same. This, by the way, although these are the data from the US, this is similar with the Indonesia in a way, right? And not only internet, even SMS, people are taking advantages of it, the criminal. Now, let's look at the solution, right? Digital only is not enough. You need to have AI-powered software nowadays. And technology matters more than ever, right? In the past, before the pre-COVID, technology is nice to have. Although we, as an individual, we have been using technology, smartphone, laptop every day. But in practice, a lot of our business still running manually. Because yeah, we'll get to it because it's still okay. So people just put in the back burner for the next few years. However, this thing changed during and post-COVID. This is no longer a nice to have, but it's a must have, right? You have to put this technology at the forefront, although the people are still running it, that's still driving the business, but you need technology to help you, right? If you want to be successful, survive and successful, you need to put this thing in place. The people still ask, you have to put a new process with help of the latest technology. And then this is also last week, Microsoft CEO said that for the past 2 months, because of working from home, because of this COVID thing, they have seen this accelerated, you know, the 2 years transformation. Now it's becoming 2 months. Some people say the past 3 years become 3 months. So I think you got the idea here. And then this is the other thing, like Zoom, we are using as a SaaS, right? A lot of people don't understand the benefit of SaaS. Even they don't even know what SaaS is, right? Even they are, if they are using Gmail, Facebook, YouTube, and all these things, Facebook and Line, they're actually using SaaS. If they're using WhatsApp, they're using SaaS. They're just not aware of it, the technical term of it. And these are some of the benefits that we outline why SaaS is the way to go in today's world. SaaS was born about 14 years ago. Many people skeptical about it, but for the past 5 years, global 2,000 companies, including government, start adopting this now. They are using the cloud computing to run their business and their government. And then this is the other thing. A lot of these big companies and government tech have this fancy security thing, but a lot of medium and small size, they are not even aware of the dangers about this cyber crime, right? Some of them, many of them actually not even aware what VPN is, right? So if you're without VPN, this is what happened. When you work from home, especially at the street level, hackers sitting in front of your home, they can hack your data, right? Now with VPN, yes, it's still not bulletproof, but at least it increased your security significantly. And unfortunately, a lot of people here still don't understand this. They are, and many of them don't even know that they are being hacked. So the other thing is this, a lot of time, almost daily basis, right? I saw these people signing papers every day, right? We actually, Indonesia since 2018 has signed the law that we have digital signature. You know, you don't need to sign paper and tanda tangan basah. You can sign digitally and it's still accepted by the government based on this regulation. So it helped us to go paperless. Right now, people are worried about touching papers. They are worried touching cash now because of the COVID, right? So this is one way not only increase your safety, but also your productivity and efficiency if we do this. This is just some of example where you can use digital approval using digital signature and the process, right? When you travel, reimbursement, conference, and all those kind of stuff that we just do this using paper. Now this is the time we need to rethink how to in this new normal. This is a lot of HR related stuff, for example, they're tightly coupled with finance and legal departments. So having this thing in using digitally is important. Like for example, when GDP invests companies outside Indonesia, we sign using digital paper. Using digital signature. When I sold my home in the US, I signed it digitally. I didn't go back to the US and sold my home. Everything go through digital signature. And then this is the other one, the rise of contactless user interface. Right now, if when I go to like my bank, like for example, ATM, you know, this teller machine, I used to put my debit card. Now, when I'm using this, I no longer use BCA ATM card. I actually use either Sakuko or M-Banking, so I don't need to take out my card because I don't want to touch it. All those machines now, because those could be the source of COVID. And the other thing is you can use facial recognition, your face become your password. Same thing, voice recognition, voice, your voice is your password. These are all AI-driven technology. And same thing with this attendance. Suddenly, fingerprint that we have been using this like during the rush hour in the morning or after when people leaving office, those are the source of COVID now. Nobody wants to touch that thing now. They want to, their attendance, they want to use their smartphone to register. So we want to use contactless as much as possible. Right now, when I touch lift now, I use a tissue. I don't want to touch it directly. Same thing, chatbot, you know, no longer that you talk to HR or manager, if they are frequently asked questions, Q&A, the chatbot is available to you 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, right? So there's no need to talk to people anymore. Now, this is the other one, work from office, like I said, like banking and hospital, a lot of these people and manufacturing, they still need to work from the office. They don't have the luxury to work from home. Like, for example, we want to detect if this is like more than 3-4 people using computer vision, we want to detect the crowd, right? And then we also make sure using Bluetooth, we want to track and trace. If you has been in touch with somebody less than 2 meters and somebody was diagnosed with COVID, we can trace it. If you notice, this is for enterprise level. This is not nationwide level. So a lot easier because we want to bring all those advanced technology for the government as well as to our medium and small businesses, right? This is a lot easier to track because it's company-wide. And then we also want to enforce, make sure they're wearing masks, right? Now become socially unacceptable if you're not wearing masks nowadays. So this is one of those things that we need to protect employees' health and safety so they could run our business. Now, this is my last slide, right? I feel like I'm useless with technology now. I cannot do this presentation. I cannot do my job and because I count a lot on technology now, right? And the other thing is this technology basically extends human capabilities. Like, for example, if by walking, we can only walk, like we can live in submarine for weeks, for days, or we can even fly with plane. Same thing with this, right? With this technology, we can work from home. We can work from office. Basically, we can work from. Thank you.